Howdy everyone, and welcome back to Subscriber Interactive, which I haven't done in a while, so this is episode number 5. Now, I've got a list of questions. I'm just gonna go through them in the order that they were posted. So Meg asks, the first game you ever played or got, and for what console? Now, the very first console that I remember having as a kid was like the old Super Nintendo. So the first game I remember playing on that was like the old school Super Mario Brothers, which, yeah, was, you know, quite fun. I'm not gonna lie, had loads of hours spent on it. Nathaniel asks, what's your favourite monster to hunt? Pretty much the one that's on the screen. Chris, with a K, asks, when you first played Monster Hunter, what monster gave you the most problems, and do you still have the same problem with this monster now? Well, the first one was probably Rathalos from the very first Monster Hunter, which was on the PS2. Because that thing was flying around so much, you just kind of thought, what am I going to do, you know, for the 45 minutes he's up there flying around like an ass? And now, not really, because on occasion I would fight Rathalos in a group, which was a lot easier. But now they've kind of toned down the fact that he flies around like an ass, and it's definitely a lot easier than it was before. So yeah, Chris with a C asks, in terms of a Monster Hunter question, what's your favourite weapon to use? I would probably have to say it's a close call between the hammer and the greatsword. I'd probably have to give dibs to the hammer though. And in general life, he also asks, what are your GCSE or A-level grades? Would you rather not answer that? Well, let's just say that I got passing grades and everything. My GCSEs I got, I think, 8 A to C grades, and in my A-levels, I got 3 A-levels. So, there you go. Wolfie actually has one of the most interesting questions that I've not seen asked anywhere else. He asks, if you had to make a set with 3 negative skills, for example, defense minus 10, and no positive effects, and play through an entire Monster Hunter game with it, which 3 skills would you pick? He also goes on to say, also no weaseling out with like reload minus 1 and saying, I'll be a blade master. I want to see you squirt. I think it would probably have to be a negative health, so I don't know, health minus 50. Divine Protection minus 10, and probably Hunger halved, so I think that's minus 10 or minus 15, I can't remember, but yeah, I'd probably have to go with those 3, because I think that would make it a hell of a lot more interesting than any of the other skills, like Attack minus 10 or Defense minus 10, then I don't see them as very kind of posing threats, if you will. So definitely the other ones I'd probably go with. Mauricio, apologize if I pronounce your name wrong, asks, what type of feline do you use, strike or slash, in Freedom Unite or Freedom 2? Also, what is the one item you find the most important for hunts? In terms of the cats, I think I went with strikes, because I found that, you know, if they could attack more with a strike and get a KO, I find it more beneficial than just constantly attacking and maybe flinching it. So that's how I'd answer that. In terms of the item I find most important, I would probably go with whetstones, because you can probably block and dodge so much that it would be alright, but with your weapon going down in terms of sharpness, well, for blade masters at least anyway, yeah, you can't really help with that. Webb has 3 questions. He asks, what was your first Fatalist hunt like? Interesting to say the least, because I stayed at a distance and just gunned the crap out of it, because that's what I had been told by everyone else. Also, do you have Monster Hunter Tri 3? I don't know if you mean 3G or actually Tri for the Wii. So I have Tri for the Wii, I don't have Tri-G on the 3DS. And finally, how do you record the game itself? Like, what do you use? Because I would love to start making my own. Because I got a PVR as a kind of birthday present, I just use that. Because I know it's a bit overkill, but that's what I use. That with the PSP 3000 with the composite cable link from that to the PVR. So yeah, there you go. And that's pretty much all the questions that I actually got. I was kind of surprised, thinking that I might get less than what was already there. So thanks for the questions, guys. And since I've got a bit of time here kind of left over, I thought I would go through, well, obviously the winners of subscriber hunts, but also maybe some updates as well, because yeah, let's go with the updates first, because I'm not really planning on carrying on with Mons Hunter as often as you guys would probably like, and here's why. Alright, because I've been playing, well, I wouldn't mind playing another Mons Hunter game, for example, Mons Hunter 3G, but I don't want to spend like £200 to £250 just to get the 3DS to play it. If it was released here in, you know, Europe, then, you know, bring it on, I wouldn't mind paying that money, mainly because I could actually play other games on the 3DS. Yes, I could import games for the Japanese 3DS, but I just kind of find that a bit useless in a way. I don't know. Like, if it was released on the PSP and I didn't have a PSP, sure, I'd buy it, because the PSP is kind of like, it doesn't have a region lock on it, from what I understand. So it would be just that much more easier to, you know, make that decision. And yeah, so once I finish the monster guides, I'll probably be doing a let's play of Heart of Darkness or one of the God of War games. So that's what I have planned, you know, once I finish these Monster Hunter guides, and maybe the occasional subscriber hunts. But as for the winners of subscriber hunts this Sunday, it will be Mauricio, Wolfie, and Chris with a C, and the game will be Monster Hunter Portable 3rd. Alright, so two videos you guys may have not seen. The video on the left is our second installment of the AVP podcast, and the name and everything will be explained in the third episode when we do that. The video on the right is the Silver Wrath Lost Monster Hunter Guide. So, with that all said and done, I'll see you guys next time. Bye!